Hello, welcome. In today's video, I'm really excited to share with you all the latest updates and news on the CMU for Android, now in version 7. This new version has brought significant improvements in many games, allowing several of them to run with incredible performance, reaching 60 FPS at 1080p resolution. While there are still some areas for improvement, the overall progress is already impressive. I tested 19 games with a focus on 1080p, and I'll show you the results. But first, don't forget to hit the like button to help this video reach more people. And if it's your first time on the channel, consider subscribing for more content on emulation. Before we dive into the tests, let me present the setup I used during the recording. For those unfamiliar, I'm using a ROG Phone 6 with a Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 GPU, 8 GB of RAM, and an external cooler to avoid thermal throttling. All the games were captured using an external card at 60 FPS and 1080p. There's no speed acceleration or slowdown in the editing, and this capture method doesn't affect performance. As for the device's temperature, during the tests, the ambient temperature was around 38 degrees Celsius, or 100 degrees Fahrenheit, so the device's temperature ranged between 38 degrees Celsius and 43 degrees Celsius. The first game I tested was Bayonetta. After the initial shader compilation, the game ran smoothly at around 60 FPS, even with a lot of action and enemies on screen. However, since we were using almost 100% of the GPU, it would be ideal to slightly lower the resolution, maybe to 900p, to ensure a fixed 60 FPS. If you watched the previous video, you might remember the color issues, but that's been fixed, and in Bayonetta, the colors look perfect. As for Bayonetta 2, we didn't have as much luck. I tested several different settings, and the game runs at 30 FPS at the beginning, but shortly after the protagonist's introduction, it crashes. Lowering the resolution to 720p and recompiling the shaders didn't solve the issue either. Batman Arkham City was initially a pleasant surprise. In enclosed spaces, we maintained a steady 60 FPS, and in the open world, the game started above 30 FPS. However, after longer periods of testing, the performance started to drop. It began at 20 FPS and eventually dropped to around 14 FPS. During the 15-minute test, there was no memory dump, but the performance drop was noticeable. The integration with the gamepad screen is functional, though I'm not a fan of this feature. The FPS drop could have been caused by thermal throttling, but since the emulator doesn't yet have an indicator for that, I can't be certain. While playing in the open world, I also noticed issues with light occlusion, where some objects turned black and didn't load correctly. Finally, I tested Deus Ex: Human Revolution, a game with advanced graphics and environments full of NPCs. There's a mod to run the game at 60 FPS, but I tested the original 30 FPS version. In this state, the game is quite playable. The colors are correct, and everything else functions normally. Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze, despite being a relatively light game, had severe rendering issues. There were several vertex explosions, which significantly impacted the experience. The game didn't freeze but also didn't respond to any commands, making it impossible to continue the test. DuckTales Remastered has been running well since the early versions of CMU, so the performance remained stable. There were no color or graphic issues, and as expected, 2D games are always the first to become fully playable. Fatal Frame Maiden of the Black Water has some of the best graphics on CMU. For those who find the game visually too dark, there's a graphics pack in the settings that can improve graphical fidelity. During one of the cutscenes, the shadows became so intense that it was nearly impossible to see anything, but this issue can be fixed with the graphics pack. The game consistently ran at its native 30 FPS without putting too much strain on the hardware, with decent color rendering, except for the aforementioned shadow issue. LEGO Batman 3 Beyond Gotham had some minor audio issues, where subtitles would appear, but the sound wasn't played correctly. The gameplay is good, and although small vertex explosions occurred occasionally, they disappeared quickly. The graphical performance is satisfactory, always running above 30 FPS, ensuring a smooth experience, though the audio still seems odd. Mario Kart 8, which previously barely ran, now reaches 1080p resolution. After compiling the initial shaders, the game experiences some slowdowns but then stabilizes. However, I can't say the game is fully functional, as I tested a complete version with all updates and DLCs, and after finishing the first race, the game got stuck in an infinite loading loop. The colors are still not rendered correctly. I made a comparison of the game running at 720p and 1080p so you can see the impact of resolution scaling on performance. Increasing from 720p to 1080p almost doubles the load on the GPU. New Super Mario Bros., which previously had discolored graphics and some slowdowns, now runs at 1080p at full speed, with no graphical defects. This was one of the most impressive games for me, as the visual quality on the capture card genuinely gave the impression of playing on a Nintendo console with higher than native resolution. In two attempts to run Need for Speed Most Wanted, the game crashed the first time. I had to disable mods to get to the gameplay. Although the game did run, all the vegetation was rendered without textures, resulting in a terrible visual experience. After compiling all shaders, the game ran at 30 FPS, which is the standard frame rate. But for racing games, 30 FPS makes the experience feel a bit strange. Rayman Legends, one of the best 2D platformers, initially seemed promising on Cemu. The initial performance was excellent, with the game running at a fixed 60 FPS, but soon the performance dropped drastically, making the game unplayable. The GPU usage hit 100%, completely compromising performance. Resident Evil Revelations, finally, would be a great port for Android if it ran decently on Cemu. The 3DS version is quite limited and has many issues, but on Cemu, the results weren't much better. I changed the resolution and tried some mods, but the game wasn't rendered correctly, and the controls didn't respond properly, making it completely unplayable. Super Mario 3D World still hasn't had its colors fixed since the last version, but in terms of performance, it already runs well at 60 FPS and 1080p resolution. There are minor slowdowns when many shaders are compiled simultaneously, causing performance to drop to around 50 FPS. However, after this period, the game returns to a stable 60 FPS. If you don't mind the color variation, you can already consider this game playable. Depending on your device, it might be more advantageous to use Sudachi, which runs the game with full fidelity. In less than a month since the release of Cemu for Android, it already surpasses Strato, which had trouble even running this game. When I saw Tekken Tag Tournament 2 getting past the loading screen, I got excited about the possibility of playing Tekken in bed before going to sleep, but that hope quickly vanished. The game has multiple vertex explosions during fights, and the characters aren't rendered correctly. However, compared to the previous version, where the game didn't even load, we've seen considerable progress. Yoshi's Woolly World, although not yet perfect, with some slightly defective shaders like Yoshi's head, the piranha plants, and other objects in the environment, runs at full speed without overloading the device too much. Maybe in the next update, the game will work 100%, or it could just be a faulty shader on my device. I played a second level to check if the shaders would compile correctly, but the same issues occurred. Perhaps clearing the shader cache will solve the problem, or it might be a flaw in the emulator. Overall, if you want to play this game, you can already have fun in its current state. Now, the most anticipated game, The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. In the previous version, the game only reached 7 FPS at 720p. Now, the performance has doubled at 1080p, but it's still not enough for smooth gameplay. So, I lowered all the effects, like shadows and rendering distance, to the minimum and reduced the resolution to 540p to try to get something playable. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough. The CPU usage rarely goes over 50%, indicating that the problem lies in the emulator's performance, not the hardware. Before we wrap up, I want to share some tips for those looking to dive into Cemu for Android. First, the performance of the games that run on the system is excellent, but not all games are compatible, so keep that in mind and adjust your expectations. The games that work flawlessly offer a great experience considering the experimental stage of the project. Battery consumption and heat generation on the device are still quite high, likely because many instructions are running in JIT mode. The emulator isn't perfect. In this version 7, the D-pad of external controllers isn't working, but in the previous version, it was. This suggests it's a bug that will be fixed soon. The only compatible file format is WAV. In a previous video, I showed how to convert your games to this format, but you can also download them directly in WAV format, saving time. All the necessary resources will be in the Patreon link in the description. There's no need to donate on Patreon to download the files, but keep an eye on it, as I always post updates there first, like a blog for the channel. And that's the video. I hope it was useful for you. Leave your test results in the comments. Thanks for watching.
Yeah. Whoa.